Bees are very hard-working creatures. In its entire lifetime, a worker bee can gather 0.8 grams of honey, and it takes roughly 1,250 bees to have 1 kilogram of the sweet stuff. It is estimated that the global honey market would reach 2.7 million tons by the end of 2023. However, according to one study, 30 to 35% of all honey in the market is fake or adulterated. What is fake honey? And what do we mean by adulteration? Let's find out. Adulteration is the adding or mixing of inferior, substandard, and/or cheap substances to a food product to bulk its volume and have increased profits over it. These added substances may be harmful, which is why food adulteration can be a serious problem. Honey is said to be the third most adulterated food product, along with coffee, seafood, milk, and olive oil. It takes a lot of bees to produce honey, and because of this, honey is quite expensive. However, to be able to get more profit from this, some manufacturers add corn syrups, invert sugars, and/or beet syrups. Although these are not harmful substances, this will alter the health benefits of honey, such as its antioxidant content and glycemic index. Detecting adulteration in honey is a challenging task and requires sophisticated instruments. For some time now, the test used to identify the presence of adulteration is the C4 sugar test. Plants produce carbohydrates through the process of photosynthesis, and this can be done through the C3 or the C4 pathways. Flowers, where bees collect nectar from, produce carbohydrates through the C3 pathway, while adulterants such as corn are C4 plants. The presence of C4 metabolites in honey can suggest that it is adulterated. However, C3 source adulterants are now being used, which makes this an inaccurate testing method. Another test for honey adulteration is through the use of a nuclear magnetic resonance instrument, or NMR. This works by placing the sample in a strong magnetic field, where the nuclei of its atoms starts to behave like a magnet and spin in the same direction. When radio frequency is applied, the nucleus starts to resonate its unique frequency. Each molecule behaves differently in the NMR, and through this, honey can be analyzed for adulterants. It's like getting the fingerprint of honey and comparing it to a database of fingerprints. In 2018, several shipments of honey to Canada were tested using the C4 sugar test, as well as the NMR analysis. 12.8 tons of adulterated honey were seized and were prevented from entering Canadian markets. None of us wants to be tricked, and while food fraud is a serious thing, still, a lot of manufacturers continue to do this practice. As food scientists, it is in our power to stop this and provide wholesome food for our community. Subscribe to our channel for more videos about the science of food. Keep safe and stay healthy.